Hello, my name is Drayden, and I will be embarking on a new adventure. This adventure means that I will be following in the footsteps of Valtteri Bottas. Valtteri Bottas is a driver for Mercedes-AMG Petronas F1 team, if that's the full name. But not only is Valtteri Bottas a Formula One driver, he's a pretty darn good one, I may add.
Valtteri Bottas has gone into the lead ahead of Vettel, ahead of Raikkonen, Hamilton and Verstappen.
Bottas has the lead. Hamilton wants it.
The two Mercedes go wheel to wheel into turn one. Valtteri Bottas just ahead of Hamilton. Bottas has that lead. It's Valtteri Bottas who wins the Australian Grand Prix. Bottas, though, is going to come back at it through Cobbs. Bottas retakes the lead. Wow! Started on pole for the US Grand Prix, crosses the line to win the US Grand Prix.
Along with his many skills and ability, he possesses one secret weapon. A secret weapon that could fit inside a bowl.
What the hell did you have for breakfast?
I had some porridge.
Porridge?
It's porridge. So, in celebration of Valtteri Bottas' win in the season opener at the Austrian Grand Prix, I'll be eating a bowl of porridge every single day until Valtteri Bottas responds. And so, let's get started. Welcome to Porridge Day 2. This is just after the Austrian Grand Prix. This is just after the Styrian Grand Prix. We all know the results of that. Everybody's talking about it online. I'm not going to talk at all about the race. There's enough people doing that. What I will talk about is what Mercedes did. After the countless things that Mercedes has done to show that they actually do care about ending racism and the drive for diversity in motorsports, they continue that by putting a black female on the podium to collect the Constructors' Trophy after Lewis Hamilton's win. Her name is Stephanie Travers, and she is a fuel engineer with Petronas. She works with fuel and oil. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm just now learning about her, but I am excited that we have people like that inside of F1. So far, it looks like Mercedes is the team that's doing the most on this issue, and they continue to back their man Lewis Hamilton and continue to put in the effort. Everybody's talking about the issue of kneeling on the grid, and that some drivers, there's six drivers who are still not doing it. I feel like kneeling on the grid shouldn't be the issue. I put out a tweet a few days ago saying, "We're wasting our time debating on who did or who did not kneel on the grid in F1. We should be focusing on educating people on the matter, reviewing if there's discrimination in the hiring process, and finding ways to create equal opportunity and respect for people of all colors." I later quote tweeted it saying, "We need to hold F1 drivers and teams accountable for what they do after the gesture to end racism on the grid. Wearing a black t-shirt and symbolizing your stance against racism needs to be translated into real life action that can create change and progress. Hashtag racism will not win." And so that's what I feel like. I feel like whether you kneel or you stand, I really feel like that has pretty much no impact. All it does is send a statement. And statements, they don't really do much. You know, a statement won't give somebody equal rights. A statement won't save somebody's life. When was the last time a statement really changed the world? Like, you could probably find some cases of it, but this kneeling or standing, it won't really do nothing. You actually have to put the effort in. And so far, Mercedes looks like they're the only team to actually be doing that. Today, my porridge is a little bit different. It's oatmeal mixed with cream of wheat with some blueberries on top. Before I embarked on this adventure, I thought porridge was just cream of wheat. And so when I found out that porridge not only includes cream of wheat, it includes oatmeal. It actually includes grits, which was pretty surprising, especially considering that grits is a very popular thing to eat inside the Bahamas. It's eaten with tuna, sausage, eggs. Porridge can include types of rice, depending on how you make it. Porridge is a food commonly eaten as a breakfast cereal dish made by boiling ground, crushed, or chopped starchy plants, typically grain. And through my research of this, through Wikipedia obviously, I found many different varieties of porridge. When I started this challenge, I never nailed down which type of porridge it was gonna be. So now I have a very wide range of foods I can try. That's gonna make this a whole lot interesting. Obviously, I don't have Valtteri's secret porridge recipe. I would really like it if Valtteri, if you know, if you can send me the recipe. you know. And Finland is about an ocean and a bit more into that direction. So there's going to be cultural differences in how people perceive porridge. And so I'm just going to, in the beginning phases, I'm going to stick with the cream of wheat / oatmeal. And then I'm going to try and expand the longer that it takes for Valtteri to respond to this. And that's it. Time to get my day started. Oh, it's especially odd this morning. You know you're becoming an adult when you get excited to see a small white bowl inside the store. I got so hyped yesterday when I saw something that I could put porridge inside of. Like, me, a 21-year-old, it's getting as excited as like a 70-year-old man about of a small bowl he could eat his porridge in. Like, this is not something I'd imagine I'd be doing in 2020. Although I had this idea since about March this year, I plan to do this experiment to eat porridge every day until Valtteri responds. Valtteri, please respond. But I had this idea from early March, and I was planning to do it the second I came back from my vacation, which was supposed to be the St. Pete Grand Prix with IndyCar and WEC and IMSA Super Sebring. But we all know that that didn't happen. None of those happened. And some of those may not happen, and some of those are delayed. I mean, the WEC race is just gone. I also bought this Tommy Hilfiger hat because every other hat that I have has a sponsored conflict with Mercedes. I have a Kamoa hat, I have a Honda hat. That was the hat that I wore in the first video. It was a piece of paper with a Mercedes logo taped to the hat over the Honda logo. I have a Jeff Gordon hat over there. I wore that in, I think, the last video or the video before that. I don't know. I've been eating porridge too long. This hat kind of looks like a Mercedes hat because it has some sort of circle icon on top of here. I'm not going to take it off. I obviously wear hats because I haven't had a haircut in quite some time. And on mornings where I basically don't even want to cook the porridge, why do you think I want to like groom my hair? Like, I'm not going anywhere, really. And so for the last, however, I don't know how much YouTube videos or videos, full reviews on Instagram, this series on Twitter, whatever I do on YouTube, I just always wear hats because it takes less time to get your hair prepared, and you know it's going to be a little bit more consistent. Thank God it's over. It was like the third time I'm recording this because the first two recordings messed up because it takes still way longer than I feel like. What? It stopped recording. All right, let's go again. Please stop breaking. I'm almost done with my bowl of porridge. The porridge is so good today. When I started this off, I knew it was going to be more than just a challenge to see if I can eat a bowl of porridge every single day. It's going to be a challenge to see if I can record, come up with something interesting to say, and edit this all while uploading it on a consistent daily basis. I'm still blown away at how Casey Neistat did basically a couple years of just daily uploads, hundreds of uploads, and he did that all on a daily basis. And his videos were a lot more complex than what I'm doing. I'm just sitting out here eating some porridge.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain.
My porridge is filled with a bunch of different things. It's blueberries, bananas, some sugar on top. It has less sugar. I'm trying to keep it a little bit more healthy. And it has a whole bunch of fruits in it. I don't know how this is going to taste. I'm sure blueberries and bananas are a pretty good combination. And it is. Damn, house is so good. Everything. I've really started to nail down the perfect amount of porridge to cook and the perfect way to cook it. You know, I'm getting down to millimeter, very small adjustments on how I make every single bowl. And it's just gonna get better from here on. Along with the many other things that I mentioned from the previous day, I think it's also gonna be a challenge to see if I can make the ultimate bowl of porridge.
Obviously, it's going to be based on my own opinion. Someone can make their own ultimate goal. But when will I reach the pinnacle of porridge? Talking about the pinnacle of stuff, the pinnacle team and the pinnacle motorsports championship. If you go back to ownerships, they're actually another factory team. If you go back from Mercedes AMG F1 and you go back to Braun, you get Honda Racing. And it's kind of funny to think that Honda Racing is now Mercedes. The factory Honda team is now the factory Mercedes team. You have a Japanese manufacturer.
What we're gonna do this episode is we're gonna predict who's gonna win the IndyCar race that is supposed to be held tonight. Tonight, July 17th. It's the Friday race of the IndyCar doubleheader at Iowa. And I'm gonna predict who is gonna win. You can leave your predictions for who's gonna win as well. Practice just finished. I did not see practice, even though I had the stream on at the start because my power went off. And so I do not know who is fast or who is strong. I'm not going to go with Scott Dixon. Although he won the last three races inside IndyCar, he's just not good at Iowa. He just does not have wins there. I think as well as the fact that the last couple years, Chip Ganassi has really struggled at Iowa. I mean, obviously, they have a new engineer, Michael Cannon. They might change that around. They might actually run really well at Iowa. But I'm still not going to put my bet on Scott Dixon, although he's kind of hard to bet against. Graham Rahal has had the season of his life. He's been driving his butt off, but everything wrong has been happening. His car didn't start in Texas. He had a good finish at Indy. I mean, the caution came out unlucky. He would have probably won that if the caution didn't come out. Road America race one, he had issues inside the pit. His pit crew made a mistake and it lost him a lot of positions on track. In Road America race two, he was set to have a pretty good race, and then he got ricocheted off the racetrack and ended his day. So I think Graham's going to be driving his butt off. I'm still not going to pick Graham, even though he's my favorite. I'm going to pick a McLaren driver. I'm going to say Oliver Askew. I don't know why. I just feel like McLaren's just going to win today. So last night I was close and still far off on my predictions for the IndyCar race. Scott Dixon had a really good race driving this way from the back. Simon Pagenaud had an even better one coming from last all the way to the win. And my predicted winner, Oliver Askew, was pretty close inside the final stages. If the race was a couple laps longer, we could have possibly see him winning. I'm going to pick a McLaren driver. I'm going to say Oliver Askew. That answer totally came out of nowhere. I just thought that McLaren were going to be fast. They were fast at like every track this season. And I just felt like they were going to have a really good race weekend. And so far, it looks like they are. Oliver Askew and Pato O'Ward, they were doing pretty darn good. IndyCar's amazing talent to find the stupidest format inside qualifying ever meant that the times from the second lap of yesterday's qualifying is the starting positions for this race. So Simon Pagenaud will start last again. Scott Dixon at the rear again. And a lot of similarities throughout the field. Like I said yesterday, it's going to be hard not to bet on Scott Dixon, and it's going to be hard not to bet on the Penske boys, because they have been amazingly fast. The only problem is pretty much 90% of the IndyCar pit crew just forgot how to do their job over the offseason. There's more times where the pit crews mess up than they actually get it right. It's like, if you're going to win a race in IndyCar, you got, like, at this point, if you have perfect pit stops from start to finish, you're probably going to finish in the top five. I think it's going to be the team with the least amount of pit stop errors, and it looks like they're all making those same errors. I gotta throw, you know what, Award. We're gonna go another McLaren driver, Award. He's gonna win the race. I'm going double dipping on McLaren this one. Hi guys, I'm stuck inside of this Heineken fine cam thingy at the 2020 Hungarian Grand Prix. I got my porridge, I'm doing well. That guy down there, he likes porridge. That guy in the black car, Bottas. Hi, go Bottas, go Bottas. Woo, let's go, let's go. You think he's actually stopped there on the track? But he's actually going so fast He's doing a lap a frame. So basically within a frame, this is a 24 frame per second video. So 24 times in a second, he's doing this lap. That's how fast the 2020 Mercedes is. It's literally looks like magic. It looks like it's stubbed there, but it's actually doing laps right now. Look at it. That thing is fast. Whoa. I mean, he's going so fast. He's already done the 2020 through 2025 seasons. Holy crap. Look at him. Blistering laps. He's going so fast, it looks like he's stopped. That, now that is ingenuity. Mercedes really knocked out the park on that one. Whoa. Hello Twitter, and welcome to a video where I'll be reviewing this.
Quaker's Real Medley's Apple Walnut. Oatmeal, sweet diced apples, chopped walnuts, tart cranberries, and multigrains.
It looks like all you need to do is pour some hot water or milk in there, which I do have. Oh, it's sticking to the bowl. The liquid is sticking. Okay. And then we're going to sit down on the side there. And I'm going to give you my full review of it. Let's see how the porridge is looking. Oh, it looks really watery. Okay. I'm going to give it a first bite. This has a lot of different ingredients in it. Normally, the last couple days I just did bananas and blueberries. But this has cranberries and apples. I feel like this would have been much better if the milk that I put inside of it was a little bit hotter and I put it in a little bit sooner. It is what it is. I can tell that this is probably the best bowl of porridge that you will get unless you decide to make all of these ingredients by yourself, meaning the dried apples and the cranberries and adding in walnuts as well. This video is not sponsored. I wish it was. That would be pretty helpful for me right now. Quaker Oats, if you do want to sponsor this video, I mean, hit me up on the telly. I mean, we can make this arrangement, dude. I, you know, I'm making porridge every day. Let's hook up this connection, man. We could be doing big things. Quaker Oats, come on. This is one of the most exciting pre-made bowls of oatmeal or quick-made bowls of oatmeal that I've ever had. This thing was just a blast from start to finish. Excitement in every spoonful. If you have these inside your supermarket, get them. I mean, these are top. Like, you're on your way to work in the morning. You only have time to, like, boil some milk, throw it inside a cup, and carry it to work. Just right here.